It's starting to feel pretty good.
I think it feels great.
Being maskless. It's almost weird to say, but a majority of community members ABC4 talked with are happy with the decision, the transition back to a life without masks.
It's definitely the right thing to be doing right now, but we were in it for so long that it felt strange at first. Definitely felt strange at first. I felt like I was doing something wrong by not having one on.
Heather Keth says she was dealing with anxiety before this week about whether or not to wear a mask. She says there was a lot of mixed messages and doesn't want to make people uncomfortable by not wearing one. Her husband, Christopher, says he has no anxiety about it, but felt like the masks were used for a political statement.
There was a while where I think it was a very political subject, and maybe come fall, I think that fell by the wayside as people realized more and more that it's real.
Walking through Liberty Park, most people were enjoying their time outdoors with or without masks. Some thrilled to have it this way, others questioning the choice, increasing their anxiety.
With something like wearing a mask or not wearing a mask, it can feel like a pretty simple decision if you just stick with that.
As a mental health therapist, Hickman says he's seen anxiety levels rise as things go back to normal, a normal where there are no masks. He says people need to go at their own pace with this decision.
Taking it primarily into account your own feeling of safety as to whether or not your own health is at risk by wearing a mask or not wearing a mask. And then also being aware of the reality that I don't get to be in charge of what other people think.
Many places within this last week have changed their mask requirements. Places like Smith's, CVS, and Walgreens all say that masks are just recommended, and as long as you're vaccinated, you don't need to wear a mask. The places where masks are still required include any medical facility, some private businesses and schools, and also on the UTA. Reporting live in Salt Lake City, Jordan Burroughs, ABC 4 News.
Thank you, Jordan.